Guys, welcome back to my channel. It's a girl, Precious Oyelike. I film about faith, relationship, business tips, and lifestyle. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about six signs that shows that you are financially literate. You know, I'm always concerned about the finance of youths, of we individuals. So why not? If not, let's jump right into today's video. The very first sign that shows that you are financially literate is that you don't put all your money in one place. You diversify your income, like you spread your income. You have income, you have various investments, you don't just have one specific investment, you have various investments, you have different savings accounts, you have different means of income. I was talking to a friend of mine in the course of the week, and she was like, oh, that she never wants to be in a state where she will only be earning from just one source, that she never wants to be there, that she knows what our parents went through because they're just receiving money from just one source of income. And she was like, she never wants to be there again. She never wants to express it again. That she wants to have at least, like, if on a bad day, at least 2, 3, as many as she can. And I could relate to her because I actually understand what she went through, where we experienced some of it together. Even though it cannot be like she actually experiencing it herself. But I will say it is not good to have your income in just one source of income. Spread your income because it's very poor that salary earners don't just depend solely on your salary. Have multiple side hustles. Like, I want to go to a stage where I can be like, oh, my 9-to-5 job is earning me like, say, 300k, but my other source of income that earning me about 5 million, 10 million. I started reading a particular blog like some weeks back. And one thing I realized from that blog was stories of people that have actually built, that have good saving habits, don't invest their money in just one thing. They spread their money from investing in stocks, in equities, in shares, real estate, agriculture, selling their skills, you mean like online podcasts, like a YouTube channel, like what I'm doing, spreading their means of income. So that they can, like the personal guy that was earning like say 100k from his main source of income, and from his other side also he's earning about 2 million naira. And I'm like, guy, quit this your 9-to-5 job. How will you be earning 100k from your 9-to-5, and from your main, from your side also, you're even calling this side also they are earning like times of your salary. Like he said, he's earning 2 million naira from his side also. Is investing, he has agri investment, he has real estate investment that pay him ROI like subsequently in a particular account, but doesn't touch it. So he just said the reason he's still working his 9-to-5 job is because, you know, he's using that money like to maintain spirit, soul, and body. And I'm like, if I'm the one in his shoes to help with that 100k, I am done. I would rather use my time and my time to invest in other things that will pay me more or yield me more value. So please don't put your egg in one basket. Spread your eggs around. Let money come from various sources. Sell your skills. Go and learn a skill. You want to have most of income. Can go and learn making photography. So many things. Have money in crypto. Have money in stocks. Have money in Evo bonds. Have money so anywhere. That's not the place I have my money in, though. And on that, I'll share it another one. Diversify your means of income. Don't put your money in just one place. Another thing is that it's also, if you are to show that you're financially literate, is for you to understand that your income tallies with the rate of inflation. So no matter how naira is devaluing, your means of income is increasing increasing day to day. So that even if naira is devaluing and your lifestyle, the expense for your lifestyle is increasing, you can still maintain your lifestyle. Like, I can still maintain your affluent lifestyle, the things you spend money on, your food you eat, your data subscription, all those things, you still need to maintain it like day in, day out. So your income should tally with the inflation rate. And if your expenses is more than what you are, like it's more than the amounts you have in your investments, that means you need to earn more. And some people that is not saving more than you need, it is having more sources of income. That is what you need to be financially free. At least to a reasonable extent, like you need to earn more source, have more side outside. There's not the number of side hustles, you know, the number of side hustles that is yielding great returns. I think that's what matters. So, we have a side hustle that is earning you, like say 10k. If you're not as well as any, like say 1 million, then you should focus more on not as any 1 million than not as any 10K, so you can yield more returns. You know what I mean? And please, we're not going to be talking in thousands on this YouTube channel. We're going to be talking in millions. Because that is the level in which I believe we are getting into. Because we call those things that being us that stood the way. So another thing that you should also understand is that if you are financially literate, like you tell me you're financially literate, you should understand the fact that you need to leave your money, like you need to be patient with your money and understand the principle of compound interest. Like, okay, I was sharing a particular investment platform with someone, some friends of mine, and they're like, oh, they cannot, they don't want that money is too small. That money is too small. The return on it is too small. And I'm like, imagine you are earning like this amount, like every 6 months, like that average, like every 6 months, and leave it for like say 10 years. Imagine how that, and like I'll be converting it to dollars. Imagine how much that money will be in the next 10 years. Or you take some months, move your money, and you put them in dollars, and you leave it for like 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. That is where the real money is. Another the principle of compound interest, not just taking your money like every, like be getting money like every seconds. There's some people like this now, when they get their ROI, straight up they consume it. I was without a bad, kind of bad habits before, but now I understand that I shouldn't be spending my ROI. I should be putting my ROI back into my investment, or be saving it for another investment, or be saving it for something, or for for baby girl life. Because I did not come to this life to come and suffer. I came to this life to come and be pampered and be taken care of. You get what I mean? So understand the principle of compound interest, and don't just follow any trending investment that you see online. If you say if you claim financially literate, then you don't just follow any trending investment. Oh, you can get 100% ROI if you put your money in this investment within 2 weeks. And sit you to sit down, ask yourself, what is you that you yourself can do that you can get 100% ROI within 2 weeks? What is not MMM? Or someone be like, oh, put the money in particular investment platform and you get like 50% within 4 hours. You to sit down, think, can I get 50% within 4 hours? Is it realistic? Like, if the investment is not realistic and you don't understand that investment, please don't put your money in it. That is why there's one when everybody's like jumping into crypto, they're putting money into crypto. Because I don't understand cryptocurrency, I don't put money there. I can't. Money is not something they can just throw away into the air. I take out time, start reading about it, watching videos about it, and I've reached the level that okay, I understand this thing a bit. Now let me put my money into it, so that if my money will not be blown away by any wind, like it's not be, I won't be tossed to and fro by any wind of maybe a dip or yeah, a dip or anything like that. So please invest wisely. Wisely, if you come to financially literate, that means you're investing wisely. And you understand the principle of compound interest. That anytime you are buying any stock, okay, I saw a particular picture on Instagram, one time like that. That a particular lady bought like five different, some individual stocks and ETFs, I think two ETFs. And when she bought those ETFs, like say, like 100 USD. And by the time she was like, after 5 years later, that ETF yielded about 1,000, she made about 1,200 profits on that particular ETF. How much are the ETF? Like she was saying, and I said, I'm like, wow, she put 1,200 on it, and that was 5 years. That was the principle of compound interest. Then she had made like say 100 USD on that on that say 100 USD when she invested it. She was like, 100 USD is enough for me, but she had left for 5 years. Money 5 years later, she made how much? People that invested in Tesla last year, Tesla people, they made mad ROI. As for people who have taken money out, if I'm the one, I will see the money there. Let the money be collecting AC there. When I'm after like say 5, 10 years, like I have some investment for a long term, I have some for short term, I have some for medium term, based on what you want to use the money for. Another thing is that if you claim to be financially literate, then you need to look for ways to reduce your costs and your expenses, to cut down your costs and expenses. If you feel like, oh, you're spending too much money on your groceries, then if you're looking for me, okay, how can I reduce the way I'm spending money on my groceries? Okay, shall we buy my groceries in bulk? But that way, we at least reduce the cost I'm spending. Or shall I just buy that? Okay, let me buy groceries for the next 6 months down. And I have to be disciplined about that. This food I'm buying is for the next 6 months. These toiletries I'm buying is for the next 6 months. Come rain, come sun, I have to use them for the next 6 months. Not just splurge them or use it anyhow. Like, just understand basic principles like that. Like ways to reduce your costs so as to use the money to do other productive and useful thing. Another thing is that you need to have, you should know now, you're financially literate, you should avoid Ponzi scheme. Flee anything that is Ponzi in nature and it is asking at the back. Flee. Don't stay. Flee. Oh, you get mad 20% ROI. Flee. We didn't have any. Like, I regretted some steps since I put the money in 2020. Like, at the point, I didn't make my profit though. It's not meant to be wise and just clear. This is a Ponzi scheme. Ponzi scheme don't last. But you see, now you understand. Ponzi scheme itself, if you understand the principle behind it, you can still cash out from it. But it's not me that I come and teach about how to cash out from Ponzi scheme. Avoid it. Avoid it. Flee any appearance of Ponzi scheme. And lastly, is that if you claim you're financially literate, then you should give yourself to learn from time to time about financial literacy, about the latest financial trends, about the latest financial investments. Like, you have to be on the edge of it. And look, this is what people are investing their money in. Study it. It's something you can put your money in it. It's something you can risk it. Like, you have to be on the verge of it. And I would recommend that you should go online, search for blogs, search for materials you can read about financial literacy. I can even read books, attend seminars, educate yourself. Like yesterday, I spent about 2 hours listening to a seminar on financial literacy that Akin Alabi was talking about, was sharing, was putting his mind, oh, how to sell to Nigerians, how to sell on social media, how to sell online. Like, I took out time to listen to it. 2 hours. That 2 hours could have, and it was 2 hours well spent. Because I can see that 2 hours in sleeping, in gisting, but it in educating myself. In the long run, it's good for my own good. And for the good of people, I'm going to spend time investing the knowledge I've received into them. I don't think I'll be giving out those knowledge for free. I will also have to charge for it because I also spent out time learning those things. So please, financial literacy is the goal. And I would love to see a generation where everybody is financially literate. That is my dream. That is my goal. So please, if you like this video, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Spread the news. People should financially literate. Educate your friends around. And see them becoming financially literate. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.